One of the first stops we're making is coming by the Gooding & Company auctions. After being out there and feasting on all those beautiful cars, and we want to stop by one of the auctions where there are some incredible cars here that are coming on the market. And so if someone wanted one of those and didn't know where to go, they didn't have to walk very far to see these cars. And this is always kind of a bellwether. There are so many unique, fabulous cars. To see what the market is like, why you see so many people out there that want to come and look at these cars in motion and in action. And this is a place they can come and see exactly how much they're worth. So we're going to be very interested this weekend in seeing what some of these cars will bring. We're here with David Gooding. And David, when you throw an event, you really throw an event, don't you?
Oh, well, thank you. Yeah, we try. We work all year on it, really. As we're tearing the tents down this next week, we'll be preparing for next year. So we're constantly traveling, looking for cars, and getting them ready for next year.
Well, with the market, is it do the cars come to you, or do you really have to go out and find them?
Oh, it's both. I mean, they come to us. Sometimes it's a little of both. This car I've been passionate about for, I remember this car as a boy, so I've always followed it and just chased it and chased it and chased it. And I've been working on the seller for years. And finally, I convinced him it was time to part with it. So yeah, we definitely chase them. But sometimes, like there's a Barn Discovery 275 Ferrari that I just didn't even know existed, and the fellow called me up and said, "I need you to sell it." So I said, "Great, you know, we're delighted."
Well, you know, it's interesting. You have superbly restored cars, but yet you've kind of made a name on some of these barn find cars, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, we like everything. We like beautifully restored cars. We like really well preserved cars. We like cars that are unrestored that are in need of restoration. So, you know, we really like all aspects of the car hobby.
Well, talk about marketing, but it's more probably the love and chasing this car, but to do a whole book on one car, I don't believe that's been done for an auction before.
Yeah, I don't think it has been done, and you know, the car deserves it. A lot of people say, "Well, you know, you're going to do one every year for other cars," and I said, "You know, look, no. This car is special. This the story behind it, the design, the people behind it. Franklin Hershey, George Whittle." Such interesting characters, and it was such an interesting time in the automotive period, the depths of the Depression, yet the height of automotive opulence. You know, this car has so much going for it that and people didn't really quite understand it, so it was something that we felt really needed to be told. And there's so many special features on this car that we had to really explain carefully. We could have done an even longer book. We had to really condense it down. So,
well, it's an amazing book. I mean, it's talk about a wonderful coffee table book. It really explains so well. And you like to say, these are one of the cars that really were kind of bespoke, weren't they?
100%. I mean, this is a true custom automobile at its finest.
And I'll tell you, you've got it in the right position. It is dazzling.
Thank you.
It is dazzling. How many years have you been doing this here now?
This is our eighth year here at Pebble Beach. So,
eight.
Yeah. Our first year, we sold Duesenberg Mormon Meteor for $4.5 million, and it was a world record for Duesenberg, and we're sure to break it this weekend. Our total sale was $14 million, so it's been a crazy 8 years.
You've done an amazing job, and you just seem to have the right kind of cars and attract the right kind of clientele, it seems, that likes your style and the way it's done.
Well, thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
And it doesn't hurt to have the tour start right outside your tent in the morning either, does it?
Yeah. No, that's a big plus. It's actually one of my favorite parts of the whole weekend.
Oh, mine too.
I get to see all the cars. You get to see them outside and then hear them fire up and watch them take off. And The owners...
They're having fun. There's no anxiety like Sunday morning.
Yeah, yeah. No, it's really a fun event. Really a fun event. And then, of course, they all come spilling in back at the end of the day. It's fun. Lots of fun.
Well, great. Well, thank you very much. We're going to watch and see how this does later on.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Good to see you, Marvie.